All right, now we'll get back to the question in just a moment. But first, we'd like to welcome Tim from the Rochester Museum and Science Center to the show.
Yes.
Tim, what do you got for us, man?
Well, we've got a few experiments for you right here. The first one we're going to do is with copper plating. And this one you can do at home. It's pretty cool, easy little experiment. What you want to do is find a bunch of pennies. Now, not just any pennies. These pennies have to be from 1981 or earlier. They have to be older pennies because the newer pennies are made of zinc and the older pennies are made more of copper. So we've got these copper pennies. What you want to do also is you take the copper pennies, you take some fine steel wool, and you're going to turn around and shine them up. The reason why is you want to take all the dirt off of them. Your pennies are probably pretty dirty from the emollients on your hands and lotions and skin and everything else.
Get them nice
so
and clean.
We get them all nice and clean. I've taken the liberty to get a bunch of them clean already. And turn around, we're going to take a little bit of vinegar.
All
right. Let me pour it in here, see if I can get it right. That's probably good enough.
Exactly that much.
There, it's close enough for government work. And we're going to pour some salt inside here. And this is the solution we're going to take. We'll take a couple of nails. Once again, we'll shine these up. We'll spin that in. We'll mix that up. And right now, we're going to take the pennies, and we're going to put the pennies inside the solution. What's going to happen is the pennies will turn around. The copper is very soft metal, and it's going to turn around and start to break down. And when it does, it's going the copper is going to be attracted to the steel nail, and it'll go right to that. We'll set that over to the side because we've got a lot to do. Inside here, we've got a little neodymium magnet or a rare earth magnet. And inside of our little jar, we've got some iron filings and a matrix, which is just a solution that's around it that's mineral oil. And what we're going to do is this is the Elvis magnet.
What we're going to you were talking about this earlier.
At the end, we'll take a look at this. What it's going to be, really super strong neodymium magnet. You can put it inside. And when you do, it starts to collect the iron filings. And when it does, you can see, you hear about a magnetic field. And you can see them because magnets stick to iron or to metal. But here you can see it in 3D. You can actually see as it goes along, and as it starts to weaken out, it sets down to the end. So there's your magnets. We'll talk about this.
It does look a little bit like Elvis.
Well, it'll look better at the end. We'll hook it up in the end. Because right now, because we've got to go to my next part, we were working with copper. And as long as we're working with copper, I forgot to mention that copper, once again, soft a little metal, and we've got some copper tubing. What the cool part about copper tubing is it's very soft. But when it's soft, you can turn around and you can bend it very easily. So it bends down. But what it also has is what's known as work hardening. When you look at copper, it's all connected together. As you start to bend it, the stress starts to come through and it starts to get little ripples in it. Those ripples interlock. Now, all of this, really super easy to bend, but now it doesn't bend back. Because all those ripples have connected together and it's locked together. So we turn around. That's a pretty cool aspect. Oh, I almost forgot. We'll take a look at, right now, we've got a little aluminum tube. And we have another neodymium magnet. Now, you notice I keep the neodymium magnet inside of the tennis ball. And that's because when you really start to look at it, it'll even catch. If you catch your fingers in between a couple neodymium magnets, it's going to sting. You got a little blister.
Okay.
And what we're going to do is take this out.
Or the break.
And we take it, and you put it against the aluminum. You'll see that it doesn't, it's not magnetic. But the cool part about it is, if we hold it right here, drop it, it drops pretty fast.
Just drops normal,
Drops really quick. But there's a gentleman named Lenz. His law turns around, and with that, the idea is if we put it inside of the tube.
Oh, look how long it took for that to dry.
It takes a little while.
Right.
Now, it does that, and it's a pretty cool reason why. Because magnets have two poles, south and north, or positive and negative. And by Lenz's law, when you take a magnet and you put it into a conducting tube, which is basically a copper tube or this metal tube, this aluminum tube, as it goes through, it starts to create a magnetic field. And that magnetic field turns around, it starts to build around the magnet. And if you take a magnet and you put south and a south together, what happens?
I don't know.
They push apart. They repel. Okay. Mm-hmm. But a south and a north, opposites attract, pull right together.
Oh, so it's kind of force. Well,
actually, that moving is generating electric current. Electric current is then generating the magnetic the field that's opposing.
Exactly. And so. Inside
and
all the way around
the delay it. For it to fall.
It actually causes a little what's known as resistance. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't fall through quite as quickly.
Oh, that one was really long.
So it's really pretty cool. Pretty neat little demo that you can do. And we'll turn around. We'll look. Mm-hmm. This guy right here. This might take you a little bit of time.
Right.
I see. Might be 15 minutes, half hour, maybe an hour, depends on it. I'd use these the other day, and I put them inside. What you really want to do is try to get the pennies to touch them. That way the copper jumps across from one to the other. It doesn't do it so quickly, but it's still a pretty neat demo. And the magnet, once again, the neodymium, you want to put it inside of a plastic container. Mm-hmm. To hold it, because if you put it through glass, you take a chance on actually breaking the glass, because that magnet is so strong. You put it in that mineral oil inside of something like a mason jar like we have it, you can turn around, seal it, you can have it for years to work like this. Mm-hmm. And actually you turn and you take a look. Once again, we've got a lot of that magnet. You can see the magnetic field. Now, the neodymium magnet that's in there is a trapezoidal shape, which means that it's going to have an angle to it. Mm. And when we do, what we do is, if you excuse me over here, because this is where it gets a little bit messy, we'll turn around, and let's see if we can get a little bit of Elvis on this.
Elvis looking,
there we go.
That's great.
Well, maybe it's Elvis on a bad hair day.
All right, right, a bad day.
Not exactly Elvis. This is Elvis after a show in Vegas. You know, it's a tough kind of a gig for him. But you can see all the iron filings. They all kind of make that little Elvis look.
Yeah, that's pretty impressive.
Thank you very much. It's really pretty cool. Yeah. And actually, working with magnets and this stuff comes out pretty nice, easy to do at home. As I said. Now, this doesn't happen really quick, the copper plating, but you have to cut a little bit of slack because we're not flying the...
Well, you can show here, Tim, what the nails look like before and then after, too.
And then after.
Up. Yeah. Now you can really see the distinct difference.
All right. And chemistry students out there...
Get the camera in there,
Your table J explains that one.
Exactly. And it's all has to do with... Physics, chemistry, it's all pretty cool. It's all stuff you can do at home. Pretty simple, easy to do. But once again, if you're playing with the neodymium magnets, be really careful with them. Because I actually today got a couple of them stuck together. Thankfully, my finger got in the way, so I could take them apart easy.
All right, well, we'd like to thank Tim for coming on tonight.
Appreciate you coming on.
Thank you very much. Appreciate you being here.
Great to have you.
Stay right back. We'll be here in a second.